In today's graphic design Illustrator tutorial, learn how to make this 3D paper illusion effect that can then be applied to poster designs and so forth. As designers, it's important to have a website to show off our portfolio of work. Bookmark offers the most straightforward and quickest way to generate an awesome website without even having to write down a single line of code, and all completed in a matter of minutes. Check out the link in the description below to learn more about Bookmark and design your website today. So firstly, you obviously need some typography or some text, and I'm using the font Elrond, and I'm going to use black or heavy as the thickness for my type. Then simply come up to Type and create outlines. From here, press A for the direct selection tool, then click on the middle or any middle sections of your type, and then press delete twice. We now have the shape foundation for our design, and we're going to need to make a duplicate, so drag it off to the side, then hold down the Alt Option key, and then bring a copy onto the artboard. We then need to make a third copy, just a slightly bit lower and off to the right from the original. So again, use the Alt Option key to click and drag diagonally downwards. Then select both of the letters, and you can actually come into the outline mode by pressing Command or Control Y if you want to. But once you have both selected, head into the Pathfinder menu and use the minus front option. You only want the top section here, so we're going to have to ungroup the shapes and then delete the lower part. Pressing Shift and X will shift the stroke of your shape over to a fill, and then again, using the Alt Option key, click and drag to duplicate this down below. You can actually hold down Shift to make sure the duplication travels at 45 degrees downwards. So when you're ready, you can now add a color to your shapes. And of course, experiment with different colors for your designs, but I'm personally going from a light kind of beige color to a vibrant pinky red. After you've learned the technique in today's video, you can of course come back and change the colors, or you can actually even change the colors at a later stage, which you're going to find out soon. You need to make sure that the top left shape is brought to the front of all layers. Then select both shapes and take the blend tool here, W is the keyboard shortcut, and then hold down Shift and click each shape once. You've now blended the shapes together, but hold down the Alt Option key and then click again here and change the mode to specified steps. Again, you can play around with the numbers for your design, but just click the preview box and change numerical values until you're happy with the design. So now we're going to need to expand the appearance, as it's not actually individual vector shapes. So go ahead and expand the appearance of your design. You can then of course ungroup them, and this is where you can change the colors if you want to, but I'm not going to do that today. On the upper left object, create a drop shadow and again experiment with the different numbers and values with the preview box checked. This will take a degree of trial and error, but once you're happy, click OK. When you are happy, you can select all of the other shapes at once and go ahead and add the exactly the same drop shadow effect, as Illustrator will remember the previous numbers. So we're nearly finished today, but to make our design look like 3D paper, I do have an effect to add at the very end of the video. So now it's just a case of taking our original shape and bringing it onto your design. Go ahead and readjust it and scale it up or down so it overlays the color sections perfectly. You then need to bring this shape to the very front of all layers, and then select everything, then right or control click the selection, and then create a clipping mask. Now that looks pretty neat, you must admit. However, there's one final effect that I'm going to add here, and that is a texture effect. Now you might think that we use the canvas texturizer because it needs to look like paper, but I've personally found the sandstone looks better than the canvas. However, this is completely up to you, but I personally prefer the sandstone effect. Finally, to give the proper impression that the actual design is imprinted inside the paper, there needs to be a shadow around the top edge. I achieve this by selecting a rectangle along the edge here, and then adding a gradient with both sides being black. However, one side of the gradient needs to have a 0% opacity. Do this for the left-hand side and the upper edge sections, and this will complete the illusion of having your 3D paper effect printed into a sheet of paper. You can then take this design and use it any which way you want to. So for example, making a poster and so forth. Let me know what you guys want to see on my channel, as I always like to hear your opinions and your feedback on my content. If you haven't done already, subscribe to my channel to boost your skills as a graphic designer and for weekly graphic design content. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.